Hey guys, so day two, welcome back. If you want to sit in easy seated, if you want your pillows, or if you want to sit up on your blocks like we were yesterday, whatever is more comfortable for you. Hope your muscles are okay today, not aching too much. And we'll start. Let's just start with our neck and shoulders up. So just look slightly over your right shoulder. Nice straight back. Just breathing in and out of our tummies. Make sure as you breathe in, you're sucking that tummy back into your spine. And then look down. And to relax your shoulders. Look up and look down. Shoulder shrugs, so bring your shoulders up to your ears and let them go. Little sigh, maybe. Hopefully, you've warmed those muscles up ready for our stretch. Oh, just a couple of rolls. Reach our hands up to the sky, just clasp your hands together, look up. And with the next inhale, we're just going to twist around to the right slightly. So you want to bring your left hand to your left knee and your right hand just behind you. And it's a nice gentle twist. And then hands back up. And then exhale to the other side. Twist is so good for your digestion. Just do your insides a nice little massage. And then come back to centre. And then just a little stretch to the right. And to the left. While we're in this position, we'll come into our bound angle pose. So feet together. Again, if you're out here, that's fine. It's wherever is comfortable for you. Again, you can even get your strap in this position or your belt, and you can hold like that. It just keeps your back up nice and straight. And then you can pull forward with your strap. That's quite a good idea to do, actually. It's quite helpful. You can have the cushions under your knees. You can have the cushions behind your knees if that's what you need to do. However, just find your comfort zone and make sure you're not in pain. You want to feel a pull, you don't want to feel pain. So back nice and straight, and then just lean very slightly forward, keeping that back straight. And then with each inhale into your legs, and exhale, relax those muscles down. Maybe come a little bit further forward. And then you just come back up and do our little pulses. Gorgeous day, it's November, it's beautiful. Oops. Put our feet in a little bit more. And then we'll come into our straddle. So legs out as far as is comfortable for you. If you want to sit up on the cushion, keep that back nice and straight. Sitting bones on the floor. Make sure your legs are tuned in, so feet flex up to the ground, and that just turns the muscles on in your legs. And then we'll get our little walking books or blocks, whichever you have, or tins. nice and straight. Pull that tummy in. Then we're just going to walk slowly forward with our blocks, just until that time, that space where we think, yeah, that's it. Don't ever overstretch it. And again, if you want to put pillows under your knees, that just gives them that little micro bend, and that helps with the flexibility as well, so that's too much of a stretch. That's another thing you can do. Nice deep breath, see if you can go a little bit further. And so my goal for you at the end of these 2 weeks is to be down on your forearms. So that's what we're going for. I'm not going to be expecting your tummy to be flat on the floor. I've been doing yoga a long time and I can't do that. Okay, so just walk back in. And you can bring your legs in a little bit here. And we're just going to walk over to the left and towards our feet. You should feel a nice stretch down the right side of your body there. Again, just go as far as you can go. It doesn't matter if you're up here. Again, you can have the pillow under your knee. And then we'll just walk across to the other side. And then just go down towards that foot as far as you can go. Remember your core, to keep your core activated. If you're right up here, it doesn't matter. Your legs, bring them together, and then just give them a little shake out. And we're just going to do a little cat and cow, but seated today. So if you want to come up on cushions, you'll be sitting on your cushions, or you can just sit up on your legs, however, again, what's comfortable for you. So we're just going to do cat and cow, but just seated. So as you inhale, you want to bring your arms back, push your chest out, push your belly out, head back slightly, and then exhale, round everything, suck your tummy back in. So inhale, and exhale. Do our supine straddle. You want to lay down to your back. Just get your strap or your belt or your towel handy next to you as well while we're here. So I'm just going to come down. Try and come down nice and slowly. Get that core involved. Vertebrae by vertebrae. Make sure you tuck your pelvis here so you're flat, your bottom of your back's flat on the floor, and knees in, and then legs up, and then legs just out. I'm just going to let gravity pull them down as far as I want to go. You can have your hands on your inner thighs, you can have them on your outer thighs if you just want to support them a little bit. You can grab hold of your toes. That's maybe at the second week we'll be doing that. progress. And then just push your legs together and your hands. And just bring your knees down to your chest. We're just going to do a little bit of strap work. So it's like a supine ball fold, really. Just pop the strap over the balls of your feet. Put your legs up. Point those toes down towards your face. And again, if you've got a slight bend in your knees, it's absolutely fine. It's wherever it's best for you. And then we're just going to pull those legs towards us. As we can go. If you want a nice long strap, you can do that. It just helps you. Relax your shoulders onto the floor. If you feel like you need a little bit more help for pulling, you can come up again for a slight bend. So with each exhale, and then just pop your right leg down and just do single leg. Bent, spine, as we reach, inhale, lengthen, exhale, and again, just what's comfortable, your knees bent, that's absolutely fine, and then switch legs over. Both knees into your chest and have a little massage your back on the floor. Okay, we're to come up. It's completely up to you. I always like to roll up. A couple of bubbles. Come over to the side and push yourself up like so. So we just end with our little downward dog. So if you want to, again, if you're indoors, you've got your couch, or if you have a chair, whatever you have available. We just grab our stool, so just bring your knees out slightly, hands on the seat, tuck your toes under, and then just come up into our downward dog. So again, walk out the dog here. It's just such a lovely stretch. Maybe come back and forth a little bit. Bring your feet in a little bit, just whatever's easiest for you guys. You just feel that lovely stretch up the back of your legs there. You can stay like that for a little while if you want to. Come down to your knees. Let's stay two. Well done, guys. I'll see you tomorrow.